I am not a geologist, pedologist, hydrologist, and I am very surprised because so many knowledge about this matter. Very interesting, very, in some cases contradictory, but very interesting anyway. As I am not a terroir man, I would like to take a little bit of your attention to what I think is the most important thing in this matter, because the important aspects for grape growers is not how to describe places, is how to manage places to make good, more, less different grapes. So I would like to send a proposal here before starting my talk about the separation between what is the environment and from that, according to the characteristics of the place, of the terroir, the base terroir, it is possible to make what possibilities, what instruments, what tools should be useful, and how can we manage these tools to enhance, to improve the final result, which is the wine, which is the most important thing. Maybe it's not my role this, but I have take the opportunity to say these things. Okay, so one of these possible tools is the rootstock. So this is a work focus on several rootstocks with a variety, the red variety Mencia. The explanation for this work is that the generalized idea of the utility of rootstocks to increase efficiency in general through the adaptation to specific site conditions or limitations, mostly soil and climate, as you know, and finally the profitability of the grape grower. Okay, so I'm not going to talk about the different interactions, but it is clear that the rootstock can be a tool to interact in different aspects, the growth, yield, and finally the what we can call in general grape quality, which is also a relative concept. In our case, in the case of Spain, the use of rootstocks has been as frequent as in any other country around the world from the phylloxera period, but this has been very limited to few options. I don't know why, but probably due to traditional grape growing in our country. I could tell that basically in the last decades the 110R has been the rootstock more used, probably related to the concept of droughts in our country, and also in some cases, especially in the limestone areas, the rootstock 41B. But other rootstocks have been less frequent. So I think that even when other technical alternatives to improve efficiency in grape growing are proposed, as for example irrigation to regulate vigor or training pruning problems or conditions, rootstocks can provide a permanent response to some of these aspects. Oh, sorry. And it's also clear that empirical observation has shown that the use of different rootstocks can lead to different results in most grape areas, even in some cases apparently contradictory. So, taking into account the importance of the site, soil and climate for the vineyard performance, in the case of the relationship with the rootstock, I think that rootstock experimentation becomes highly relevant to know the options to make the grape growing activity as much profitable as possible in each condition, in each place or location. So the objective is get an approach to the influence of several rootstocks. In the case of red variety Mencia, through the quantification of several parameters of growth, production and quality in the DO Bierzo, as we, as we are going to see in next picture, because the experimental trial was developed in the area of the province of León, but in the area of Cacabelos, the appellation of origin Bierzo. The vineyard was planted in 2002, and the period of study was carried out during 4 years, as you can see in the picture. And we have followed a no irrigation regime, with an average for the last for these 4 years of about 540 millimeters per year, with the temperature, average temperature of around 12 degrees centigrade, and a soil, we are not going to describe deeply the soil, because but it's a deep soil with more than 1 meter to the vines to explore, well and right drainage with a slight slope in the orientation east to west. It can be classified as a sandy clay loam as the area surrounding the experimental trial. The training system we have used has been the BSP with pruning as a bilateral royal cordon with 10 watts per meter and distances of 3 meters between rows and 1 meter inter vines in the row. And the row orientation has been east, northeast to west, southwest, and the treatments have consisted of 10 different rootstocks with a classical experimental design of 4 replications with 30 vines per prod, and 10 of them have been used for control. These are the rootstocks we have tested. I'm not going to say anyone, because we are going to see the results. But first, I can show you what is the general idea of the climate, talking about temperatures and precipitations. As you can see, from flowering in the middle of June to of the beginning of June, it depends, to final of August, we are around 20 degrees centigrade as an average temperature. But what is more important is that there have not been rainfalls from the middle of June to the end of September, a little bit in August as some storms, but not important. So this accounts for a total precipitation on average a little bit more than 500 millimeters per year, but the most surprising is the variability of the precipitation from less than 200 millimeters to near or practically 900 millimeters in 2010. So this is a usual variability in precipitation. So we are going directly to have a look to the results with this variety. We have observed what rootstocks has been the more vigorous, 5BB and 1103 pulsing, have behavior with a higher vigor. A little bit more than 428 and SO4. And much more than 110R, which in some cases is supposed to be a vigorous rootstock, and also 101/14. The increase from the highest 5 dB with respect to the lowest 101/14 has been around 40% in measure as pruning weight. If we look to the individual vigor of the shoot, we can see that again 5 dB and 1103 pulsing have the highest values, which explains the final result in pruning weight. And the lower result has been for 101/14 and 110R. The difference on average between these two groups, extreme groups for vigor, has been 64 grams per shoot in the first case and 51 in the second one case. To summarize about the growth, 5 dB and 1103 have been a higher growth, whereas 101/14 and 110R clearly had a lower growth, mainly due to the reduction of the shoot vigor. Talking about the grape yield, we can see that SO4 and 428 have been the more productive, followed by 140 Rouget. In the first case is 6.3 and 5.7 kilos per vine. And the second one a little bit less than 5.7, and the less productive has been 101/14 and 5 BV. So the increase of SO4 with respect to 101/14 has been also near 40%. The explanation for this yield result can be found in the number of clusters per vine, where SO4 and 428 have been again the highest, and the lower has been 101/14, closely related to the grape yield, the final grape yield. But also cluster weight has been responsible for this final behavior, with a higher value of SO4 and 428 with near 285 grams per cluster, and intermediate values from other rootstocks. But to highlight that 5 BV has been the lowest with only 235 grams on average. The very weight has explained partially this result, with superior values of, something happened with the presentation, anyway, 1103 pulsing, 140 Ruggeri, and 16149 and 333 EM, the highest values, and lower for 5 BB again. So 5 BB has got a lower yield because of the smallest berries. The number of berries per cluster has been again a component to the final result, with highest values of SO4 and 428, and lowest values from other rootstocks, but basically 101/14, which is quite less vigorous and less productive. To sum up, there were clear differences in yield, highlighting SO4 and 428 as much productive, and on the contrary, 101/14 and 5 BB the less productive. As we have seen, the variations of grape yield were due to the change in number of clusters and on the in the cluster weight, which in turn was due to the number of berries per cluster and to the berry weight. Looking at the balance, we have found that some rootstocks like 110R, 41B and SO4 have got higher values, and the lowest have been got by 5BB and 1103 poles. Moving to some parameters of grape quality, we have found some interesting results, like the higher values of 5BB and 10114 and 1103 poles, which have been the less productive rootstocks, and lower values of 41B and 110R, which, on the contrary, have not been the more productive rootstocks. The title acidity has shown that 110R and 1103 got higher values, and 3EM and 10114 the lower, related to pH of the mast. 5BB again, which was the highest in sugar, show the higher value of the pH, and the lower came from 110R, 41B and SO4, which are these two last, 41B and SO4, were the more productive, one of the most productive rootstocks. Yeah? Okay, so tartaric acid has shown some results, 41B and SO4 highest, and lower 333VM, 140 Ruggeri. Malic acid, which can be more interesting, have in this case has shown 5BB and 1103 with higher values, but pay attention to the fact that these two rootstocks were the highest in growth, in vigor, and the lowest 10114, 41B, 110R, lowest in sugar. Okay, potassium has shown the values, the higher values of 5BB, lower of 41B, 10114, and no clear differences in total phenols. So we can summarize that the use of different rootstocks has affected the response in growth, yield, and quality. And the rootstocks 5BB, 1103 poles were the more vigorous, 10114 and 110R the less vigorous. The rootstocks SO4 and 420A the most productive, and the less productive were 10114 and 5BB. So the influence of rootstocks in grape quality was variable. As we have seen, the sugar concentration was higher in 5BB, especially, and in 10114 and 1103 poles, and lower in 41B and 110R. Consequently, the choice of the specific rootstocks with Mencia should be according to the evaluation of the response to the conditions, environmental conditions, and the intended productive and qualitative targets in its local growth situation. To make a point of attention, it should be like the summary of the behavior of a group of rootstocks for a determined variety in a particular area, which is the more important tool that the future grape grower can use to decide how to manage the local conditions of the base terroir, which was my idea at the beginning of the presentation. So, for example, and it's the last First is 5BB was a surprisingly very high growth rootstock, very low yield, but high sugar, pH, malic acid, and potassium, for example. Okay, so this has been my talk, and I want to thank you for your time here in the site.